by the time that he was 18 years old, Prince Frederick William of Prussia, known to his family as Fritz, had lived through a revolution, seen his father forced to flee the country in disguise, and seen other kings toppled from their thrones. With the monarchy left in such a precarious position, it was wise to remain silent about his own views of the necessity of a constitution and a more liberal approach to Prussian politics. On a more personal level, too, torn between his militaristic father and his more intelligent and liberal-minded mother, he had learned to keep silent in discussions to avoid upsetting either parent. Although he was naturally cheerful and an affable boy, these tensions left him prone to depression, which became more pronounced as he grew older. While studying at the University of Bonn, he developed a particular interest in British literature, British politics, and the British Constitution, and was delighted, therefore, when Prince Albert invited his family to attend the Great Exhibition in 1851. Everything he saw delighted him, and he was particularly struck by the closeness of the British royal family and the mutual devotion between Prince Albert and Queen Victoria, which contrasted so sharply with the constant bickering of his own parents. Prince Albert was equally impressed by the diffident young man, with whom he shared his vision of a unified Germany led by Prussia. In fact, he was so impressed that he saw the potential benefits of a future marriage between Fritz and his own eldest daughter, the highly intelligent Vicky, who as yet was still a child. The years went by, and conveniently, Vicky and Fritz fell in love. They were married in January 1858, beginning one of the greatest love stories of the age. Fritz and Vicky shared Prince Albert's dream of a peaceful, unified Germany. But when Fritz's father became king, he showed himself to be an autocrat, and became increasingly dependent upon his new minister-president, Otto von Bismarck. Although Fritz disagreed with many of Bismarck's draconian policies, his oath of allegiance to his father and his sense of filial duty prevented him from contradicting him, and once again he was reduced to silence. He quietly continued his military duties, and in 1866 he played a major role in the Austro-Prussian War. The soldiers serving under his command were so impressed by his willingness to share their hardships and his courage in battle that they adored him. He became their idol, and they referred to him as our Fritz. 4 years later, he played a major role in the Franco-Prussian War, which paved the way for German unification. On the battlefield, Fritz was hailed as a hero, and even his enemies were touched by his humility and his respect towards them. But when the war was over, and the German Empire was declared, the new Chancellor, Bismarck, had little use for a liberal-minded Crown Prince, and Fritz was relegated to the sidelines. For the next 17 years, his views were silenced, and he sank deeper and deeper into depression. On a bright summer's day in June 1887, a procession of mounted kings and princes moved sedately through the streets of London in celebration of Queen Victoria's Golden Jubilee. Amid such illustrious company, all eyes were drawn to the towering Lohengrin-like figure of the future German Emperor Frederick III, in his imperial helmet, silver breastplate, and the brilliant white uniform of the cuirassier guards. The cheering crowds could never have believed that he had less than a year to live, or that our Fritz, the hero of Königgrätz, Worth, and Sedan, would soon appear as little more than a silent portrait hanging on the walls of history. So often throughout his life, duty, modesty, and loyalty had obliged him to remain silent, concealing his own achievements and stifling his opinions. By the time of Queen Victoria's Golden Jubilee, Fritz was already suffering from an incurable throat cancer, and when his father died the following year and he became emperor, he was barely able to speak. To those who knew him well, he truly deserved the epithet Frederick the Noble, for his heroic stoicism in the face of suffering equalled and even surpassed his courage on the battlefield. You can read more about him in my new book, The Silent Emperor, available in Kindle and paperback formats. Thank you for listening.